All right, everybody, what is up? We are back. This is season 5, week 1. This will be me versus Devlin, the Safari Salandits versus the, sorry, names are new. What is Devlin's new name? So something, I think it's the Sand Spring Sandcastles. Let me double check that though. It's just called the Sandcastles, so. Alright. Got my participating team, Electric, Salandit, my mascot, Staryu, Tentacool, Ferroseed, and Drillbur. I did not bring some of my aces because this is non-conference play, and it's kind of just an exhibition, really, if anything. So I don't want to give away anything too soon. Alright. I'm gonna lead my lead that takes down most of his Pokemon. I assume that his Dewpider is especially defensive, so I'm hoping that Staryu will be strong enough to take it out. We'll see. Deciding on which Pokemon he's going to lead. He's probably assuming I'm going to lead Tentacool because of Toxic Spikes. But I'm just going to try to hit him pretty hard and see how that works. Yep, leading Dewpider, which I anticipated. Ah, shiny Dewpider. Shiny Dewpider is cool. It looks like a virus. Alright, now there is no Dynamaxing, so. Left him in. Probably gonna get a Sticky Web, and then he's gonna switch out into what I assume is Mudbray. So we'll get one of these off. He knows that I have Rapid Spin on this Staryu. I mean, surely. Rapid Spin gets rid of Sticky Webs, right? I assume so. Oh, he didn't switch out. Surf. Interesting. One problem gone. Alright. No Sticky Webs. We're doing well. One up on Devlin. Devlin's a good trainer, so we'll see how this goes. I've got speed on pretty much everything he's got right now with that speed boost. So, I avoided the attack. Wow, that missed. Interesting. He might have a fire type move on. That's gonna do some damage. I assume Mudbray comes out here. Or Pumpkaboo. Stinky. Question is, can Staryu absorb this drain punch? Because if it can, then we're in the clear. But if he kills me with it, then we're in a lot of trouble. We gotta switch out as well. Good switch out. He's got to know the Hydro Pump's coming. But I don't think he has anything that can absorb a Hydro Pump. So he goes first. Which means I'll have the analytic. Wow, survived with one health. So if this hits, big power. Yeah, that's rough. That one health coming in. Mudbray is a pain, so Mudbray being gone really helps me out. Bug and poison. That's gonna hurt. Take away my Eviolite. That is really harmful. He's assuming that I'm gonna be going for Toxic Spike here. But he has two Pokemon that can get rid of him, so Toxic Spikes don't help me at all. I don't do as much that time. Try to get the burn. No burn. Come on. Get the burn. It's gonna lay toxic spikes. Getting so unlucky with those toxic spikes. Save Tentacool, because Tentacool can get rid of Toxic Spikes, so he can land it, but... I knew he couldn't resist that. Get rid of my pivot Pokemon.
Oof. That hurts.
That'll get rid of the toxic spike, which is good. Right, we're 3-1 right now. Although I've got two Pokemon that are pretty hurt. But he's also, his Trubbish is hurt quite a bit. Castle short. I wonder if I could kill it with two hits. Probably not. Maybe. Let's give it a go. It's probably got berry juice. He doesn't know that I'm focus sashed. That rock polish hurts. He might have me with that stupid sandcastle. It's faster than my fastest. It's probably got something for him. Hopefully, I'm able to survive this Earth Power special attack, and Tentacool is specially defensive, but I don't have my Eviolite, so... Yeah, I think he's got me beat. I think he's gonna sweep. I don't have Eviolite on my Drillbur either, so Sandy Gas probably has it for him. His Electrike can't hold up. Not with that Rock Polish. He's probably questioning what item I have on Drillbur right now. I can get rid of the Sandy Ghast, I think I have it, but it's 3-3 right now and he's got the advantage. Look through. What's he sending out? Now this should kill. Ah, that is so unlucky. Last time. don't think that'll kill. Apparently it did. Great. It's probably Choice Scarf. If he's Choice Scarf, he's got this. That hit pretty hard, though. Yep, he's Choice Scarf. But he missed because of Hustle. That won it. If it wasn't for that miss, I would have lost. I could still lose. But I should hit first on this Sandy Gast, and it should win me the game. Good job, Devlin. Now we go on to game two, play with the same rules. So I think I want to save Staryu for later. Question is how. I imagine he still leads the same combo. This is good for me. I get to get free flamethrowers off. Surely he won't leave him out there for that. But I get a free flamethrower, so. Wow, he left him out there. He might live this without the choice specs. But the burn. Which is also incredibly lucky, considering how much I would buy. It's gonna hurt, but not enough. Electrike didn't do anything last match, so this time he's actually doing something. He feels like he's doing something. So my switcheroo is useless. I can at least get a volt switch here though. He probably goes before me. Oh, nope, I went first. Thank you. Oh, he's switching out. Crap. That's not good. In comes Mudbray. Actually, can't switch in Mudbray because he knows that I can one-shot it. Yeah, that doesn't hit. Wasted turn. Let's see if this kills. I know it raises defense, but... did not expect that to kill it. Sandygast is his best Pokemon there. It was hard for me to kill the first time. Hey Devlin, can't Sandygast learn Giga Drain? I don't know if that's what you're going for there, but... Alright, so this guy definitely has Ice Punch. Alright, he has Ice Punch Superpower? Alright. Yeah, that hustle's really hurting you. I assume that he's still faster than me with his scar. So I'm gonna try to get that analytic. That might kill. No. He's sacking right now or what? Yeah, he gave up. Yeah, I just got really lucky that time. Well, we survived week one. Devlin, he said that he didn't have Pumpkaboo, which is one of his better Pokemon. I know because I played him on Smogon with it. And he beat me fairly often on Smogon. Probably definitely more than 50%, so he probably would have won if he had Pumpkaboo. But these non-conference games are just exhibitions, so they don't really mean anything. Hopefully he gets his Pumpkaboo soon, and we get to see him really in action. But that was week one. Thank you so much for being here. And I will catch you guys next week for week two. See ya.